Standard Life, Subject Social Science. This is the sixth video of Chapter 1, which is the rise of British rule in India. In this particular segment, we are going to discuss about economical as well as social impact on India by the British East India Company rule. So, first thing was no material producers. So, India became a country who was producing just a no material for England, and the people over there in got raw material from India and were weaving clothes out of it and making other, all the things, all the wealth was being drained out from India and making Britishers more prosperous. Other thing was dual power policy. Bengal has certain right to market muslin, silk as well as cotton, but there was a dual power policy which is called Dvimukhi Shashan Padati, according to which a Nawab has responsibility of public welfare and British East India Company has the power to collect revenue. So, Nawab has responsibility without power and company was enjoying power without the responsibility. So, this made fanning off the Bengal state itself. Next thing is unfair revenue collection for peasants. So farmers, the most difficult situation was for the farmers. Farmers has to pay the revenue whether there is a drought or heavy rain. In the both the cases, farmer has very less product out of whatever he was doing. So India is a country all farmers and due to this unfair revenue collection, so India's farmer became sad or unpleasant, and due to that, the whole country we can say became unpleasant. Taxes on cotton industries. This British East India Company was applying unfair taxes on cotton industries because at that time India has very good weavers who were weaving very good clothes. So quality of this particular cotton, dhaga, sarma, and all was better than England. So what do they do? They apply taxes, more and more taxes. So instead of giving taxes to the Indian weavers, what that it is easy to buy and resell the cloth which is coming from England. So tamare pen lagi hoy, and tamne dukandar paase jaun 15 rupiya ne marti hoy, and suppose biji koi pen che 5 rupiya me tamne easily mari jati hoy, to tamne directly each pen le so 5 રૂપિયા ની ઇઝલી મળી જાય કે 5 રૂપિયા ના 10 રૂપિયા ની મટીરિયલ લઈ આવવાનું પછી એને બનાવવાની, તો એ એક ડિફિકલ્ટ જોબ થઈ જાય ને, અને એટ ધ એન્ડ જે ગેઇન હોય એ પેલા ની અંદર વધારે જતું હોય. સો ધીસ ઇઝ વાય ડ્યુ ટુ ધીસ અનફેર ટેક્સિસ કોટન ઇન્ડસ્ટ્રીઝ ઓલસો કોલેપ્સ. ફોર્સફુલ એગ્રીમેન્ટ વોઝ ડન બાય વીવર્સ. સો બ્રિટિશ બિઝનેસમેન કેમ ટુ ધીસ વીવર્સ એન્ડ આસ્ક ધેમ ટુ ફુલફિલ ધ કન્સાઇનમેન્ટ વિચ વોઝ ઇમ્પોસિબલ ટુ બી ડન ઇન ધેટ particular time. And if they forcefully signed their agreement with the weavers, and if they won't be able to do so, then they will make charges on them, and sometimes they need to go to jail also. So conclusion was, so before the rule of British East India Company, India was a country full of villages, and this villages was self-reliant and independent. But due to company rule, villages became poor and dependent. So certain good thing also happened in that era, that is starting of railway line between Mumbai to Thane, starting of steamer between India to England. ઇન્ફન્ટ ડિસાઇડ્સ નાનો બાળક હોય જો એ ફિમેલ હોય તો એને કિલ કરવાની એક પ્રેક્ટિસ થતી હતી. વિડોઝ છે, વિધવાઓ છે, એના રીમેરેજ માટેની કોઈ પોસિબિલિટી નહોતી. તો આ બધા જે સોશિયલ કસ્ટમ્સ હતા એને બેન કરવા આવ્યા. ઓબ્વિયસલી આની અંદર રાજા રામ મોહન રાય હેઝ કન્ટ્રીબ્યુટેડ અ લોટ અલોંગ વિથ હેમ મેની મેની અધર પર્સન વોઝ ધેર એન્ડ હી ફોર્સ્ડ બ્રિટિશર્સ ટુ પાસ પાસ અ લો વિચ વોઝ ઇનએક્ટેડ ઇન ધેટ ટાઈમ. સો ધીસ વોઝ અ સમથિંગ વિચ ઇઝ બેનિફિશિયલ ફોર ઇન્ડિયા, પીપલ ઓફ ઇન્ડિયા. Next is administrative work was emphasized. Whatever administrative work was there, before that there was a Vahi Khata and all Munsi and all people were dealing with the everyday post and purchase. But when British East India Company came to India, the whole work was started in English. So Anglo-English system started in India. So therefore, all the administrative work was carried